Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to perform post operation in MySQL database with the help of Flask Python. So the prerequisite of this video is going to be you must have MySQL workbench as well as Python installed in your system. So if you don't have that, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top and watch the video. I've already done an entire tutorial on that. So if you have everything perfectly set, let's get started. So we'll be requiring three steps to complete this. First, writing the connection code as well as creating the MySQL database and table, then writing the post route, and final thing is hitting the post route from our Postman. So let's begin with the code. So we'll be requiring two packages. One is going to be the Flask package and next one is going to be the MySQL connector. So just open the terminal, new terminal over there, and you need to run the command pip install flask and MySQL hyphen connector hyphen python. Just hit enter. That's it, the packages will be getting installed. Now just go to the folder and create a new file. Let me name it as new.py. So as usual, we will be beginning by importing from our packages. So it's going to be from flask import flask with capital F, be careful there, and next one is going to be import MySQL dot connector. That's it, this is going to be our import. Next, we will be creating our flask variable, which is app equal to flask within bracket underscore underscore name, just specifying the default directory over there. And next is we will be achieving this connection with the help of a connection variable. So let me name the connection variable as db equal to MySQL dot connector dot connect. So this is going to be my connection variable, and open circular bracket, and within this only we will be passing our host name, username, password and database. So first is going to be the host name, within single quote it's going to be localhost since we are running in our local system, and next one is going to be the username, user equal to root. This is my username. By default, most of you will be also having this. So if you can't figure out what's your username, just go to MySQL Workbench and in the connection, right click, and you'll be having the edit connection option. Click this, and here you can see we'll be having the username. So just put it there. And next is going to be the password. So enter your corresponding password. I will enter mine over here. And final thing is going to be the database name. So database. So let's go and create a database in our MySQL workbench. So just go inside your connection, and this is going to be the command that we will run to create a database. Create database, your database name. My database name is my database. So select this, run it, green mark, and if you refresh it, here you can see my database has been created. Just copy this name and put it over here. That's it, now we are done with our connection variable. Next thing is we will be creating our route, okay, the post path. So go to the next line. For that we'll be defining a function. It's going to be function add student. So I'm going to create a student table and then I'll be inserting value. So I'll just have the function name as add student, and here we will be specifying the route. So it's going to be at app dot, which is basically this flask variable. We need to use that here. It's going to be route, then circular bracket, we need to specify the path. It's going to be slash add student. Basically, we will be hitting this path from our Postman. And next, we need to specify the type of operation. For that, we'll be using methods equal to post. So we are defining this is a post operation. So we are having get, delete, update, right? So this is a post operation. So this is fine now. And next, go inside the function. We'll be getting the data from the Postman, right? So from Postman, we'll be sending some data like this as a request, request body. So we need to cache that data. So for that, we'll be having data equal to request dot get underscore JSON. So we need to import this request from flask comma request. Have this, there has gone now. And in the next line, we need to get the name and morg. So name equal to data dot get name, morg equal to, I'll just copy this, data dot get morg. So to avoid confusion, let me go and create the table now. So the same my database, the database that I created a moment ago, I will just use that, and I am creating a table named student, which is going to have three columns, ID, name and mark. So I'm specifying ID to be auto generated. That's the reason why I'm having auto increment. So we won't be giving this ID value from our postman. Instead, we will be only giving name and mark from our request body like this. So I will just run this. Yeah, table has been created. If I refresh this again, tables, students is there. So columns, ID, name and mark. So now, since ID is auto-generated, we won't be passing that value. So from our postman request, we will be passing only name and mark value. So name and mark values are being passed from here. And in our code, we are getting the request and storing it in data. Then we are restructuring that data. We are storing the name from this data in name variable, mark from this data in mark variable. So each value, this value will be stored in name, this value will be stored in mark. That's what's happening here. Simple. And next, we will be accessing the cursor object from our connection variable. And with the help of this cursor variable only, we will be able to perform or execute MySQL queries. So it's going to be cursor, you can name this variable anything, equal to db, which is my connection variable, db dot cursor within circular bracket. And next, we need to specify our SQL query, all right? So in the next line, it's going to be SQL underscore query equal to, within double quotes, we'll be writing our insert query. So it's going to be insert into table name. In my case, the table name is students. I'll just copy this. And within circular bracket, you need to specify your column name. So in my case, the column names are name and mark. Next is going to be the values space. Here you need to put percentage yes, comma percentage yes. Okay, so this is how it's going to be, and we will be replacing this percentage yes with our name and mark values like this. So it will get replaced and this insert query will be running. Okay, and in the next line, this is where we will replace. Okay, cursor dot execute, basically we're saying execute this query, and within this we'll be passing our query variable, which is SQL query comma within circular bracket name comma mark. Okay, so name will be going here, inserting in the name column, mark will be going here, inserted into the mark column. Simple. So this value will be getting inserted. So this cursor.execute basically maps the query with the value that we are passing from our postman and then executes it. So simple stuff. And final thing, we need to have db connection variable dot commit. Okay, so without this particular line, after inserting the name and mark into the database, the save operation won't be done. So this basically saves the value permanently in our table. So we need to have this, really important. If you skip this, any changes happening in your table. So make sure that you're adding this connection variable dot commit. And final thing is, we will just return a response to postman. Okay, it's going to be return JSONify. So a circular bracket and a curly bracket. So we need to import this from Flask as usual. And we can just have something like message, and it could say posted something, and at the end you need to have the status comma 200, which is successful. That refers to successful status. You can have anything over here, you can even send some JSON, you can even send the name and mark here, it's up to you. Final thing is, we need to come outside of this function. This is the post function, just come outside, and we need to have our main function over here, that is the starting of the program. So it's going to be if underscore underscore name, which is the default directory path, equality underscore underscore main. So we are just referring to the code that this is going to be the starting point, okay? And in the next line, it's going to be print. We just have a connecting to DB, something like this, just a statement. And we will start our application. It's going to be app, which is the Flask variable dot run. Inside you can specify the port number, or you can even have debug equal to 2. That's totally up to you. So I'm saving it. This is the code, basically, guys. Simple stuff. So I'll clear the terminal, and for running this, the command is going to be Python space your file name dot py. Just hit enter. Here you can see the application has started, and by default it's running at port 5000. Okay, so now we need to go to Postman. We need to make a few changes over here. First thing is, you need to change the operation to post. I guess by default it will be in some other one. Change this to post. Next, you need to add this http colon double slash localhost, and our port number is 5000. Okay, and just copy this add student and put it over here. And next, you need to go to body, click on body, you need to go to raw, and you need to select here JSON. So by default it will be in text. You need to select to JSON, and you need to add a curly bracket. Within that, you need to have name within double quotes, mark within double quotes, and you need to have the value. And since mark is of type integer, mark is of type int, I'm not specifying here double quotes for mark, and name is of type string, that's why I'm specifying double quotes. So you don't have to specify double quotes for integer. So now everything is set. And if I go to my students table, currently it is empty. Here you can see I don't have any values inside it. So if I just hit this path, I'm getting the response 200, everything is fine. If I rerun this again, here you can see I'm getting the value. And if I go to my Visual Studio Code, here you can see this particular path has been hit. It also says the date, the time, and the operation, and the response status also. So if you want, I can just change the value something, send it and rerun it, and I'm getting that value. And the ID has been auto generated. I'm only sending the name and mark. So you must also have that in your mind. You must have this int auto increment primary key. You need to have this stuff. Okay, basically that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I done a lot of data operations in PostgreSQL, MySQL, MongoDB with the help of Flask, Spring Boot, Node.js, and other AI APIs and tools. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.